Hello guys, welcome to Passive DFT channel. In this channel, you will get information regarding DFT and VLSI. So, our today's topic is what is fault analysis and how scan chain masking will work in EDT and how bypass logic will work in EDT. We will see this topic in detail. First topic we will see is fault analysis. What is fault analysis and where it will take place, as well as what is the solution for fault analysis. So, what is fault analysis? Here, in this diagram, you can see there are two scan chains, scan chain 1 and scan chain 2. In between that, one circuit disturbance is there, where one value is there, which is written in green, that is correct value, and one faulty value is there, that is zero value. Because of the circuit disturbance, these values are present in scan chain 1 as well as scan chain 2. Once these values will go to XOR gate at output to the scan chain. There you can see at the output of XOR gate, scan chain 1 value, because of this scan chain 1 value, you will get good value as a 0, and in scan chain the faulty value is 0 0. So at the output you will get faulty value is 0. So here we are not able to detect between good value and faulty value. So this terminology we will call as fault analyzing. Fault analyzing is present at complex logic, where so many XOR gates are there. What is the solution for fault analysis? The solution is, we will keep one AND gate at a scan chain output, and through that AND gate we will pass the signal to the XOR gate. Because of these modification, we are able to control the scan chain output. If we will provide one at the other node of AND gate, we can pass the scan chain to the output, and if we will keep 0, here we can see in scan chain 2 at AND gate node we kept 0. So we will block the propagation of scan chain by this technique. So because of this, we are able to observe a single scan chain at the output. So this is the solution for fault analysis. What is scan chain masking and why we have to perform that? So in figure we can see two scan chains are there. In every scan chain, X values are present. X value means unknown value. But X value in one scan chain will disturb the same top of other scan chain as well. Here in yellow box, we can see the output that we will get at the XOR gate. Here we can observe correctly that if one scan chain is faulty, other scan chain will get disturbed. So we have to perform same thing that we did in fault analysis. Solution for scan chain masking is, we will add AND gate at the output of scan chain, and we will control that AND gate operation through other node. So here we have added two AND gate at the output of this scan chain, and we are going to control the operation through AND gate, where if we will provide 0, that will block scan chain propagation towards XOR gate, and if we will provide 1, it will propagate this scan chain pattern to the output XOR gate. By using this technique, we will observe single scan chain at a time. This is the solution for scan chain masking. Our last topic of this video is EDT bypass logic. How EDT bypass logic will work? Here you can see our input is coming through scan channel, and normally it will go to decompressor, but in bypass mode it will bypass the decompressor as well as compactor. Here we can see that blue line which is bypassing decompressor and directly going through the can change, and at output it will again bypass to compactor, and through mux we are getting that channel output. By using this technique we will able to observe a longest can change, and to control this operation we will use EDT bypass signal to control the bypass mux present at EDT logic. Thanks for watching this video. Please like, share and subscribe. If you have any question, please post that question in comment section.